Ritu Phogat and Nam Hee Kim. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Phogat comes out jabbing. Nam Hee Kim catches the jabs with her lead hand. Fingers extended, open palm. Nam Hee Kim 1-0. Ritu Phogat, her pro debut in mixed martial arts. Looks for an early takedown. Does the multi-time wrestling champion. Gets it, goes to side control. Great start here from Ritu Phogat. Trying to put her in the guard is Kim. Phogat tremendously strong from the top position. Bounce back to her feet. Up kick there from Kim. And Phogat's going to let her stay. Phogat backs out of the way of the jab. You see the height and reach. The size goes the way of the South Korean Kim. Phogat takes a leg kick. Right glove high for Ritu Phogat. Tries to catch the kicking leg. Big scooping takedown attempt there from Ritu Phogat. And gets Kimono back again. Side control once more for Ritu. Pressing that shoulder on the jaw of Kim. Applying the pressure from inside the half guard. Is she going to posture up and work the ground and pound here? Keeping herself pressed close to Kim at the moment, Dragon.
Kim's doing a good job of stopping the first attempt at the takedown, but she's falling short on the second attempt. That's where Phogat's really applying that pressure. She continues to chase the takedown. Now she's going to try to pass over into side control. Kim's doing a good job of holding on to that half, but I think it's just a matter of time before Phogat slides that knee right through.
Ritu Phogat showing tremendous composure in her debut. Again, that shoulder applying pressure on Kim. Referee Olivia Coles keeping a look at the action, making sure Kim's okay. The top pressure from Phogat, still looking to pass to side control, still inside of half guard though, the Indian. You hear the corner of Ritu Phogat saying, keep her back on the mat. The position every wrestler wants their opponent in, back on the mat. The position every wrestler doesn't want to be in. And she's back to her feet. Charges in, now gets the side control. Nicely done there by Phogat. The options are many from here. She can drill the knees, drill the elbows, look for a submission. Cuts the hips in. The corner's calling for the elbows. Tries to pin the arm. Here comes the right hand! Ritu Phogat. Swinging away with the right hand. Like Virat Kohli at the cricket crease. Strapping that right arm of Kim. Right hands are plenty from Ritu Phogat. Kim nowhere to go. The face exposed.
Kim's got to move. Referee's going to be forced to stop this. She can't defend herself.
Dominating her. Absolute domination. Pounding away with the right hand. Is it over? Is the referee going to stop it? Kim, no place to go. Wide open for punishment. Phogat rains it down. The Indian owning her. Is she going to sign the pink slip? She does. Sign the ownership papers. It's good night, Irene. Ritu Phogat gets the win for the Phogat family. For India. What a victory for Ritu Phogat. She has a There's a new rising star in the atomweight division. There's a new star to watch from India, and her name is Ritu Phogat.
And she just got that crucifix position and just kept beating on Kim. Gave the referee no choice but to jump in and stop the match. I was impressed by the way she went back into the ground position. She just ran right by the guard, didn't even give Kim a chance to lock her guard back up. Finished in side control and then just ground and pounded her way to a huge victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 37 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Ritu Phogat.
And we'll
Chao Chen needs to keep it standing and work that kickboxing and sounder technique.
You can already see Ritu Phogat is nice and light on her feet. She's on the balls, moving around, pushing forward, controlling the center of the circle. Wu Chao Chen's got to keep her head moving and also keep her stance a little bit lower, lower her center of gravity, just in case Phogat tries to slide in and attack one of those single legs or double legs.
Wu Chao Chen does have an impressive 18-2 kickboxing and sando record. Can she hammer the legs, try to slow down Ritu Phogat here in the opening round? Phogat controlling center circle. Wu Chao Chen on the outside now comes forward. Needs to commit here, though, the Chinese athlete.
Phogat's not rushing forward. She's not exposing herself. She's just nice and controlled. She's controlling the center of the circle, putting out that jab, testing the waters with a nice straight right hand.
It was a tremendous debut last time out for Ritu Phogat against Nam Hee Kim of Korea. Kyoto with punches, 2 minutes 45 in the opening round, and she'd want to keep that trend going tonight. Ritu Phogat, there's another solid right cross. Now moves in three. Double leg, looking for a takedown, trying to put Wu on her back. Gets her on the ground now for the first time, and this becomes Ritu's world. This becomes Phogat's world.
Watch out, buckle the head, watch out.
You can see Wu's trying to push down on that head. She's trying to work her way back up. Phogat's gonna try to suck her hips away from the circle wall there and really control that individual leg and then just slowly work her way into mount and then let that ground and pound start to come down.
Here comes the heavy right hands from Ritu Phogat. Where does Wu Chao Chen, Miss Red, go from here, Dragon?
She's gotta turn, yeah. She's gotta go onto her other side, get onto her right side and start moving away. She's got her back up against the circle wall. I'd like to see her try to use that. See, right there's that handcuff position I was talking about earlier, Michael. How she's got her hand trapped like that, so she can't defend that side, but she also can't use it to post. Now she's able to defend that and get back up to a neutral position, start working from the guard.
They will be glued to this one in India. Ritu Phogat, can she go 2-0 tonight? Looks to posture up, close guard now from Wu Chao Chen. 2 minutes 35 remains, first round set for three. Opens up the guard now to the Chinese athlete. Ritu looking to pass on that left side of the body, but can't go there.
She's trying to step over the leg, but Wu's doing a good job of just maintaining that guard, keeping her head nice and close. You know, if she can stall the action here, if she's unable to work her way up the circle wall, she might be able to force a stand-up if she can control that head. I would expect Ritu to posture up a little bit more, start looking for those elbows. Up there, here they come.
Elbows now from Ritu Phogat. The ground and pound is so powerful on this Indian. Still the close guard from Wu Chao Chen. The Indians have come on incredibly strong in one championship over the last 18 months. The likes of Ritu Phogat and Pooja Tomar and of course Arjun Bula, Gary St. Lyon Mangat and a whole lot more. With over a billion people in their corner, so to speak, Mitch.
You can hear the brand new head MMA coach over at Evolve Mixed Martial Arts yelling at Ritu to start working, start passing. Sayer Baharzada is a veteran of the game, so he knows how to work these positions. This is one of his specialties, was to take people down and beat on them inside the guard.
Commonwealth Wrestling Championships gold medalist Phogat. 11 years younger than Wu Chao Chen. As we move towards the final minute of this opening round, peppering right hands there from Phogat. Tremendous resilience, though, from Wu Chao Chen, Dragon.
Yeah, she's doing a good job of staying active. You know, she's not. She's also been able to keep her guard in place and not allow Phogat to really start to pass and develop that ground control. But what we're seeing, though, is a lot of top control, just controlling the head. You can see the way she's kind of got a can opener on the top of her head and just kind of prying that up and then pulling her into the punches to just deliver a little bit more force.
Our very educated ONE Championship fans worldwide knew this one would not necessarily be a walkover for Ritu Phogat. Only 60-40 voting in favor of Ritu for the win tonight on the ONE Fantasy Game, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, now available on the ONE Super App. 60-40 in favor of Ritu Phogat, Dragon.
Yeah, she has just so many fans. I asked her about that. What's it like to have the support of a billion people from her home country in India? And she says she thrives off it. It gives her motivation every single day to wake up early and get the job done and be the hardest worker in the room.
Wu Chao Chen survives the first round against Ritu Phogat, which will all go well because they will begin the second round from a standing position, which is where Wu Chao Chen wants to be in India. Big hello, watching on Star Sports Select 2 and Hotstar, cheering on Ritu Phogat. Also in the USA on BR Live, the Philippines, in Myanmar, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia, and a whole lot more, over 150 countries. Don't forget, folks, to give us a follow on your social media at One Championship on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. A closed-door event tonight in Singapore. And Zhong Jinan, you see the world strawweight champion in the corner of Ritu Phogat, the team from Evolve MMA. Second round of three. Good opening round for Ritu. A good survival from Wu Chao Chen. She is still here. And she'll feel that as long as it's standing, Mitch, she'll have a real decent chance.
Yeah, but she's got to be a little bit more aggressive with the hands. She's got to earn the respect of Ritu, and I'd like to see her step in, start committing a little bit more to that jab. But she's got to be careful with the kicks. When she's throwing these kicks, it seems like she's a little bit off balance, especially that inside leg touch that she's trying to throw right there. Because she's leaning forward, she gets right into that.
Oh, look at the takedown there. Made it look so easy, Ritu Phogat. Top position for the Indian inside the opening 20 seconds of the second round. Indian wrestling, Mitch, one of the strongest wrestling nations in the world, India, and you are seeing one of their finest here in Ritu Phogat.
Yeah, she's really coming into her own, and she's got such a good team with her at Evolve Mixed Martial Arts, surrounded by so many different world champions, and we're really going to start to see a lot of her striking improve. They've got so many great strikers out there, it's just going to be surprising to watch her improve in that striking element.
You were talking about the popularity of Ritu in India earlier on, Mitch, and really, I mean, you know, cricket is the number one sport in India, no doubt about that. It's the national sport, but outside of cricket, wrestling is right up there.
It's right there, and I think they are hungry for mixed martial arts. I think that is a country that is waiting to find a superstar, and they just might have it in Ritu.
Ritu Phogat in control, second round of three, top position inside the closed guard of Wu Chao Chen. Mitch, is it a big adjustment for a wrestler like Ritu Phogat going into mixed martial arts and having to, you know, learn the ground and pound, which you can't do, of course, in wrestling competition?
You know, it is, but it's also instinctual for a lot of, you know, wrestlers to start ground and pound type training because they're already used to being on top. They're already used to controlling opponents, and they say it's really the best base to, you know, have in mixed martial arts because it enables you to dictate where the match takes place, and that's what we're seeing right now. The way that she has that handcuffed position right there where she's controlling the left arm, Wu is not able to do anything, and you can see how she's able to utilize that. That is not something that's used in, you know, wrestling. They're not used to, you know, locking down hands. They're used to locking down hands and then going for takedowns and control the positions, not dropping bombs. And we're seeing how Ritu is starting to adjust and add those different elements to her game.
Is Ritu doing any damage here to Wu Chao Chen, or is this, you know, is this Wu Chao Chen just trying to close her down and not receive the full impact of the ground and pound from Ritu?
You know, you can see that she's kind of keeping her guard closed and trying to pull down on the head. I think she's waiting for a possible stand-up. You can see she's not really opening her guard. She's not really trying to attack with sweeps or submissions. She's kind of just accepting this position and trying to hold on. You can see the overhook she has on the left side there, but she's just trying to control the head. And I think Ritu's just too strong in the grappling exchanges.
Ritu Phogat raking the elbow, dropping the elbow. Under 2 minutes remaining in this second round. More elbows off the right arm this time from Ritu Phogat.
I'd like to see Ritu maybe try to pass this guard. Posture up, push down on the legs, try to step over and advance her position. She's very comfortable here. We saw this in her debut. She likes to sit in people's guard and smash on them. And that's what she's doing here. But she's, I don't know if she's going to do enough damage to get a TKO victory like that.
Mitch, meanwhile, if you're in the corner of Wu Chao Chen, what are you telling Miss Red to do right now?
Man, she's got to go for broke. She's got to change the destiny of this matchup. She has got to open up her guard and scramble, try to create some movement. Because right now, there's nothing she can do holding the posture. Right now, she should try to push off the hips, right? If she takes her feet, puts them in the front of her hips and starts to extend her legs and push, she's gonna have a better shot. But she also leaves herself open to things like this. Now she's working her way back up. That's what we need to see from Wu. Now she's gotten back up. Now she's gotta separate.
Can she separate and work that kickboxing and Sunder technique with that impressive record of hers in both sports of 18 and 2? Formerly undefeated as an amateur, 8-0, 2-1 as a pro, with one submission win for the BJJ blue belt, Wu Chao Chen, Miss Red of China.
Look at the head of Ritu. She's driving her head right up under the chin of Wu, and that's enabling her to keep her pressed against the circle wall. Wu has got to take that right arm and try to get an underhook on that side so she can do something with it. The underhooks control where the body's going to go. And as long as Ritu has that underhook there, it's going to be difficult for Wu to really go anywhere.
Need to the midsection there from Wu Chao Chen. Final seconds of this round.
See, she's trying to turn away. She's trying to sneak out the side, but because Ritu has those underhooks, she's able to press her up against the circle wall and pin her there.
Nice little elbow on the inside of the left arm from Ritu to end the round. Very good stuff from Ritu Phogat. She is in control, Dragon.
Look at this beautiful duck under double leg, the spin, twirling her around, putting her on her back, and then just beating on her. See the way the left arm is hidden? That left arm is being held into position by Ritu. So she is able to just smash on her without any deterrent whatsoever.
Don't forget, folks, the Apprentice One Championship Edition with Chatri Sichitong is coming soon if you want to be a part of it. If you think you've got what it takes to work alongside Chatri Sichitong at One Championship, simply go to Chatri's Instagram, go to Chatri's Facebook page, and you'll see the details of how to apply to become the Apprentice at One Championship. Third and final round. Ritu Phogat has been dominant. Let's see if Miss Red Wu Chao Chen of China can keep this one on the feet.
She can't stand still. She has to start circling. It's her back leg, the way she's picking it up when she commits to the strikes. It's going to be pretty easy for Ritu to duck under the punch and slide right in for a double leg. That's a nice little overhand right landed by Ritu.
She's landed that lead right hand a number of times. Ritu Phogat, there's the overhand right again, transitions into a clinch here with Wu.
See, Wu's got to get that underhook and start digging and start prying her up, because otherwise she's going to go for another ride. Right back down to the canvas. Now you can see, now Ritu's starting to be a little bit more aggressive. Now she's in half guard. Let's see if she can slide that knee through the legs of Wu and end up in side control and possibly look for another submission finish.
Half guard position for Ritu Phogat. This is judged as an overall bout, but no doubt first and second rounds was all Ritu Phogat. And this really is dangerous territory for Wu Chao Chen.
This is where Ritu got that submission last time. She attacked a Kimura on the far side arm, and she's looking to do the same thing right now. See how she's looking? She's trying to frame off that arm, control the side. See how she's driving her knee into the hip? That's going to prevent Wu from going anywhere. And Wu might even give up her back on this one.
Side control for Ritu Phogat. Looks to go to the mount here. Can't get there yet. Wu Chao Chen trying to defend the mount attempt from Ritu. Is she going to give it back to Ritu? No. There goes the right hand. There's the elbow to the hairline. There's one to the orbital, one to the temple. The heavy ground and pound from Ritu Phogat. And Wu Chao Chen in a whole lot of bother, still with a long time to go in this third and final round.
That's, you know, Wu's pretty tough. You know, she was able to get back into half guard, which is an important position to control one of the legs of Ritu. But see how she's getting flattened out under her back? She can't do that. She's got to get an underhook, and she's got to start working her way back up to her feet. Underhooks are so important. So you know what Wu's going to be doing tomorrow is she's going to be studying those underhooks, because it's enabling Ritu to control the grappling exchange.
Ritu Phogat, top position. The ground and pound has again been on point for the Indian. And Miss Red has got to find a way to get back to her feet. Here come the elbows and the knuckles turned in off the right hand from Ritu. Looking to maintain that undefeated record and go 2-0 tonight. The Commonwealth Wrestling Championships gold medalist.
But Wu's got a good, she's trying to get onto her side. She's trying to hip escape so that she puts just one side of her body on the ground rather than having her back flat like it is now. That's that pressure. That's that strength coming from Ritu. Wu's got to try to get onto her right side. She has to try to put her right side on the mat and then start moving away.
Wrestling, grappling is in the blood of Ritu Phogat, who would wake up at 3 a.m. to train nearly 6 hours a day from childhood. Has wrestled for over 17 years, more than 300 competitive matches. And here she is again on the biggest martial arts stage in the world, one championship, and dominating Wu Chao-Chen of China.
See, it's just that strength. It's just from decades of grappling on, grinding on people, and just controlling their bodies. It is the best base to have. There are a few, holes in Ritu's game, which I'm sure she's going to tighten up, and that's going to come from hunting for a submission. It might be a darce right there. If she would let her to turn over onto her stomach and reach, she might have been able to slap in a darce right there. But she's close, but she is able to control every single exchange, and that's what's so important.
So far, Mitch, it's looking like Phogat's going to go 2-0, and you've got to be impressed with this blossoming career with the Indian.
Yeah, she's really putting things together. She's around the best camp, that she could get around. She's got some world champions that are going to help her refine her game, but she's got to have that finishing instinct. She's got to sense these opportunities, and she's got to go hunting for them. Wu is making a few classic mistakes, and I would like to see Ritu take advantage of them. Work to pass that guard. Really start hammering down. You got 36 seconds to make an impact here.
Half a minute remaining, and Ritu Phogat in control, as she has been from the opening bout. Tremendous resilience, though, from Wu Chao-Chen of China. Not waving the white flag, not giving up, still here. But she will not be able to find a way to her feet with Ritu on top of her. With only seconds to go now, Ritu continues to grind away at Wu Chao-Chen. And it looks like Ritu Phogat is going to continue her winning ways in the mixed martial arts universe, which is tremendous for her, tremendous for India. Ritu Phogat, impressive once again.
Yeah, it was a dominant performance from pretty much start to finish. Just a 15-minute butt kicking, and she was on top, and she was dropping those bombs. But this is what the story of the match. She was able to get the takedown in each of the rounds and then keep it there. Didn't expend a lot of energy, was just able to control the top position. A very smart performance. But what this is doing is this is enabling Ritu to get getting in there, getting comfortable with the bright light shining down on her on the biggest stage in the world, and putting on performances like this.
Going down to our judges for this one. I don't think there's any doubt in anyone's mind that Phogat will get the nod here. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Ritu Phogat.
Two exciting young atomweights on the rise, the future of this division. Wearing the Kun Khmer trunks in the Cambodian colors is NSP Nusray Pop, the wrestler, the superstar from India, Ritu Phogat. Trained out of Evolve MMA here in Singapore. Ritu controlling center circle early on, thrusts out the jab, counter right cross there from NSP. On the One Super app, 68% of fans have tipped a win for Ritu Phogat tonight. Already the wrestling superstar looking for a takedown. shooting in for a double leg.
Yeah, you can immediately see that Ritu got nice and tight with that pressure. She tried to back NSP up against that circle wall. Now NSP's got to start digging for underhooks. Ritu's going to try to suck that leg in, try to get nice and tight, turn the corner, and put her on her back just like that. And she lands in side control, a dominant position for Ritu.
This is Ritu's world. This is Rituville, exactly where she wanted to be inside the opening minute 10.
Now she's going knee on belly. Here comes that ground and pound. I don't know if she's going to try to circle away and maybe sit in full mount. Nice bridge from NSP, though, to work her way back up to her feet. Now she's got to start digging for those underhooks. Control the body of Ritu. Do not let Ritu get her hands around those legs.
Phogat switches to a single leg. Good work here from Ritu. But NSP trying to maintain her vertical base. Once again, side control now for Ritu. Goes to knee on belly. The confident start from Ritu Phogat. She is so dominant down here. She can work submissions. She loves the ground and pound.
Ritu's got really good control, especially in this top position. You can see NSP trying to hold on to that head, but it's actually given her a possible choke. Ritu can grab onto her head and drive her shoulder into her neck and pull off a Von Flu choke, which is a risky position for NSP to be in. NSP needs to get her back up against that circle wall and start working her way back up to her feet.
Alan McGoon telling us earlier this week that NSP has been training her elbows from the clinch and knees going up. Says she plans to use the knees on the single or double leg attempts from Ritu Phogat.
Toss off the fence.
At the moment, it's Ritu trying to pin that right arm, open up the face to those ground and pound shots off the turning left hands. The face wide open here of NSP.
Ritu
taking advantage.
Gives her a little bit of space, though, and NSP is able to start working her way back up to her feet. Good job by NSP, but she's got to separate from this clinch.
The audience here inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium appreciating the return to the feet of NSP, landing some knees. Now they're back down on the canvas. Closing down that right leg is Ritu.
You can see just the control that Ritu's got. NSP needs to separate her legs if she can work her way back up to her feet. She's given Ritu that trip, and so it's easy to lace that leg and drag her back down.
Let's go up to finish.
You can see, watch Ritu just slowly work and methodically adjust her positioning so she can keep beating on NSP from the ground and pound position.
Both these athletes looking to break into the top five, maybe the most stacked division in all of ONE Championship. The Atomweights, Angela Lee, the undisputed queen. Denise Zumbawanga, number one. Mingbo, number two. Lina Schwinn, number three. Mei Yamaguchi at four. Stan Fairtex at five. Good raining down on the left hand there from Ritu Phogat. Postures up now, does Ritu. Looks to drop the elbow on the nose. There's one to the kisser. Good work here from Ritu. This is what she does so well. Sits inside of half guard and plows away with the ground and pound. This Indian wrestling sensation goes to side control now.
Beautiful pass there. You're just watching Ritu's game evolve. Since she's been in a ball mixed martial arts, she's upped her levels. And we're seeing that here. She's not just grabbing. She's not just trying to hold on to NSP. She's trying to beat on her from dominant positions. In this side control position, she's going to be able to do a lot of different submissions. She's either got Americanas, Kimuras, or she could go knee on belly and look for the mount.
Hey, go, keep going, Ritu Phogat wants to send a message to the atomweight contenders, particularly to Stan Fairtex, that she is knocking at the door for a top five berth. Cuts the hip in momentarily, and again here from side control does Ritu, with 25 seconds remaining in the first round, set for three. It's been all one-way traffic, and the traffic is driven in the direction of Ritu Phogat.
Good control from Ritu, how she's able to sit in those hips, adjust the position. She's looking for the crucifix.
10 seconds.
But all NSP's trying to do is bump her way out of it. There's that mount that I was talking about. Here comes the ground and pound. NSP might survive this round and make it to the second.
Stop.
She does survive indeed, but it is pure and utter dominance from Ritu Phogat. We're going to roll into the second pick. Hello to all of our fans watching around the world, to Josh Berman in Hong Kong, and to Jenk and Jalen Bahich in Melbourne, Australia.
see it's just that topside pressure coming from Ritu Phogat. She just gets on top and she just starts hammering the ground and pound over and over. NSP needs to create that separation. She needs to sprawl heavy and not let herself get backed up against that circle wall. She has to keep moving because we know what Ritu Phogat wants to do. She wants to work her way nice and tight, get that single leg, drag NSP down to the canvas and start beating on her.
Not too much heavy breathing in the corner. The ice pack applied there on the chest of Ritu. A little bit of a cold press and end swell on the forehead of NSP. Don't forget, folks, follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, back. And Instagram.
Ready.
Second round of three.
Let's go.
First round was all Ritu Phogat. Outside leg kick from the Cambodian warrior, NSP. Changes angles, looking for the inside thigh kick, perhaps. Goes the outside thigh. Good counter right there from Ritu. Ritu just moves off to her left to cut off the counterclockwise circling of NSP. NSP trying to stay away from the power side of Ritu Phogat. Needs to open up with the Kun Kamai and the Letway technique here, does NSP. Glancing right hand, drifts off clockwise now. Fake there from NSP. On the outside, this is exactly how Ritu began the first round, setting her control of the center of the circle.
A lot of leg kicks coming off of NSP right now. You can see she's trying to do damage to that lead leg, but Ritu is actually sliding out of the way of that leg kick. She can't just throw him blind like that. She's got to put some hand combinations together because we know what Ritu Phogat wants to do. She wants to punch her way into the clinch and get this back down to the canvas, but she's doing a good job of showcasing some nice boxing.
The Indians have come on so strongly in One Championship over the last 18 months. Double leg here by Ritu, gets the takedown. Ritu on a mission to become India's first mixed martial arts world champion. Make her family, her famous family, and her country proud.
Oh, look how what Ritu's doing. She laces the legs off of that takedown. She was able to get her legs in between. See how she has her legs in between Ritu's? Now Ritu's just going to slowly work her way up, and here comes the ground and pound. You can hear these heavy shots landing on NSP.
NSP taking the GNP at the moment. It's heavy from Ritu Phogat. Can Nusraipov find a way back to her feet or find a way to close down the rampaging Ritu? Ritu managing to posture up, turns the knuckles in, hammer fist strike, downward elbows stop, now. Stop. It's relentless, it's over, it's another win for Ritu Phogat. She sends a message, she does a cartwheel in celebration. Ritu Phogat is for real. She's coming for everybody. Ritu Phogat is coming for everybody.
Very dominant topside pressure. She looked good in the stand-up. She improved her boxing skills, but it's the way that she pressures her opponents. She traps them up against the circle wall with nowhere to go. Starts touching them up with the boxing, gets in tight on that takedown, and then once she gets you to the ground, she just starts hammering on you. NSP is tough as nails. There was no quit in this young lady. The referee was forced to jump in and halt the action. But another big win for Ritu Phogat as she's working her way up that atom weight ladder, Michael.
Another strong Indian performance in One Championship. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 2 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Ritu